Hello students, in our previous class what we have discussed is we have solved few problems on Coulomb's law and electric field intensity due to point charges. In this particular session, let us solve problems on electric field intensity due to a line charge. Okay, so let us consider the fifth problem statement. A uniform line charge of infinite length with line charge density rho L is equal to 40 nanocoulomb per meter lies along z axis. Find electric field intensity E at the coordinate -2, 2, and 8 in air. The medium given is air medium. How to solve this kind of problem? Okay, let us see how to solve this problem. Before going to solve this, let us describe the given problem statement. So what is given? A uniform line charge of infinite length has been given, which is lies along z axis. Let us consider the z axis. So consider the z axis, a uniform line charge of infinite length. It varies from plus infinity to minus infinity. So we can show this as a uniform line charge, means let us use positively charged line along z axis. So which is having a line charge density rho L is equal to 40 nanocoulomb. Rho L is given by 40 nanocoulomb. We need to find the electric field intensity at this particular coordinate. Let P be the point. Let us consider a point P which is at the coordinate -2, 2, 8. This is the point P. So which is at a distance r from the origin of this particular infinite line charge, which is at a distance r from the origin of this particular line charge. Let us consider this origin as O. Since this origin is located on z axis, its x and y coordinate values are 0, and z coordinate is equivalent to the coordinate of this point. Therefore, coordinate of this particular origin point is 0, 0, 8. This is not given, but according to the problem statement given here, you need to calculate the coordinate of origin. Okay, now the distance between these two points is considered as r. The vector acting along the line OP is towards the point P. This is the direction of unit vector acting towards the point P. Let OP is the perpendicular line drawn to the line charge. OP is the perpendicular line drawn to the line charge, infinite line charge. This is the problem statement given. Based on the given problem statement, we have written this diagrammatical representation, right? And let us solve this problem. We know the equation for line charge density. Rho L is given by 40 nanocoulomb. We know that line charge density is charge per unit length. Okay, so charge is given, rho L is equal to 40 nanocoulomb, charge per unit length. We know the electric field intensity equation also for infinite length line charge, that is E is equal to rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon naught into R into A cap R. This is the equation we have derived for infinite length line charge. Electric field intensity due to infinite length line charge. We know this quantity. Rho L is known. R, we don't know the value of R. So 2 pi epsilon naught, what is the value of epsilon naught? 8.854 into 10 power minus 12 farad per meter. This is the value of epsilon naught. We don't know the unit vector, A cap R. We need to find the unit vector, right? A cap R is equal to R divided by magnitude of R. How to calculate this vector R? So as per the previous problems, so we need to use the rule tip minus tail in order to calculate the length of this particular line segment, that is minus 2 minus 0 into a cap x plus 2 minus 0 into a cap y plus 8 minus 8 into a cap z whole divided by square root of minus 2 whole square plus 2 whole square plus 0. 8 minus 8 is 0. Therefore, a cap r is equal to minus 2 a cap x plus 2 a cap y divided by square root of 8. This is the equation we have got for unit vector. Substitute this quantity into the electric field intensity equation. What we are going to get here, see, E is equal to rho L is 40 nanocoulomb. 40 into 10 power minus 9 divided by 2 pi into epsilon naught, 8.854 into 10 power minus 12 into r. What is the value of r? Root 8. Value of r is root 8 into unit vector. What is the unit vector? Minus 2 a cap x plus 2 a cap y divided by square root of 8. Right? This is the resultant which we have got. Therefore, electric field intensity E is equal to, see, 20 into 10 power minus 9 divided by pi into 8.854 into 10 power minus 12, root 8 into root 8, we have given with 8, into minus 2 a cap x plus 2 a cap y. If we solve this quantity, we are going to get 90 into minus 2 a cap x plus 2 a cap y. Minus 2 a cap x plus 2 a cap y into 90. If we solve this quantity, we are going to get 90. E is equal to, take 2 outside, 180 into minus a cap x plus a cap y. What is the unit? Volt per meter. This is the electric field intensity at point P due to the infinite length line charge. Understood? This is how you need to solve the problems regarding the charged line. Okay, let us solve one more problem. Okay, let me read the problem statement. A line charge of 2 nanocoulomb per meter square lies along y-axis, while surface charge densities of 0.1 and minus 0.1 nanocoulomb per meter square exist on the plane z is equal to 3 meter and z is equal to minus 4 meter respectively. Find the electric field intensity at point P. You need to observe that in this particular problem statement, there are two different charges. One is line charge and another one is surface charge. So this problem statement is a combination of both line charge and surface charge. At point P, so electric field intensity is contributed by both line charge and surface charge. Therefore, how to solve this problem? The total electric field intensity E at point P is equivalent to the electric field intensity from line charge and electric field intensity from surface charge. We need to sum up both the things in order to get the total electric field intensity, right? This is the overall theme of this particular problem statement. Then how to write the geometrical shape for this particular problem statement? Let me see. A line charge of 2 nanocoulomb per meter square lies along y-axis. We need to write the axis first. One is, this is z z-axis, this is y-axis, this is positive y-axis, this is negative y-axis, this is positive z-axis and this is negative z-axis. The x-axis is in this direction, this is x, this is minus x direction. This is the origin, okay? The line charge is located along the y-axis. Therefore, line charge is placed along this y-axis. Okay? This is what given. The surface charge densities of 0.1 and minus 0.1 is located at z is equal to 3 and z is equal to minus 4 respectively. So, a surface charge is located at z is equal to 3 meter in the positive z-axis and z is equal to minus 4 meter in the negative z-axis. Got it? And let point P is the place at which electric field intensity to be identified. The coordinate of this point given is 1, comma, minus 7, comma, 2. And point M is the place along the y-axis which is perpendicular to this y-line. The distance between P and M is R. Got it? Distance between P and M is R. What is the coordinate of this particular point M? The coordinate of this particular point M is 1, comma, minus 7, comma, 0. Since the x direction is 0 at this particular, z direction is 0 at this particular point, the coordinate at point M is 1, comma, minus 7, comma, 0. Okay? We need to find the electric field intensity at point P due to line charge by using these two coordinates. We need to find the electric field intensity due to surface charge by using the given equation for surface charge equation. Okay? Now, how the electric field intensity affects when two different surface charges are given? See, one charge is 0.1 nanocoulomb per meter square in positive z plane and another one is having minus 0.1 nanocoulomb per meter square in negative z plane. So, we need to find the overall electric field intensity due to both the type of surface charges. Therefore, the solution, surface charge, electric field due to surface charge is given by rho s divided by 2 epsilon naught into a cap s. This is the equation. And electric field intensity due to line charge is EL is equal to rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon naught into R into a cap R. These are the two equations. We need to substitute for rho S, a cap S, rho L and a cap R and R in order to obtain ES and EL. Later, after obtaining ES and EL, you need to substitute into this equation in order to obtain total electric field intensity. Before going to that step, the first thing is calculate ES. Surface charge density, by using surface charge densities, calculate the electric field intensity at point P due to two infinite area surface charges. Okay, that is ES is equal to ES1 plus ES2. Why ES1 and ES2? See, electric field intensity contribution from the positive z-axis surface, that is ES1. Electric field intensity at point P due to negative z-axis surface, that is minus 0.1 nanocoulomb. Got it? So, we need to calculate ES1 and ES2. And one more thing, according to the convention of charges, so we know that the electric field intensity is pointed away from the positive charge. So electric field intensity is towards the negative charge, negative surface charge. Got it? These are the convention, and AZ is acting along this point. AZ is acting along this point. Okay? With this convention, let us solve for ES1 and ES2. ES1 is equal to rho S1 divided by 2 epsilon naught into A cap S. See, A cap S is opposite to this, hence it is minus A cap Z. A cap S is equal to minus A cap Z in this direction due to the opposite in direction. Got it? Then ES1 is equal to, what is the value of rho S1? Rho S1 is 0.1 nanocoulomb, 0.1 into 10 power minus 9 divided by 2 epsilon naught into A cap S. What is the value of A cap S? It is minus A cap Z into A cap Z, minus sign comes here. Keep ES1 as it is. Then substitute for ES2. ES2 is equal to rho S2 divided by 2 epsilon naught into A cap S. ES2 is equal to, what is the value of rho S2? Minus 0.1 nanocoulomb divided by 2 epsilon naught into A cap S. What is A cap S here? It is equivalent to the A cap Z direction. Both the directions are same here. Hence, A cap S is equal to A cap Z in this particular case. Then, so keep these two equations and try to add. ES is equal to addition of these two. Minus 0.1 into 10 power minus 9 divided by 2 epsilon naught into A cap Z, minus 0.1 into 10 power minus 9 divided by 2 epsilon naught into A cap Z. What is the result? ES is equal to minus 0.1 into 10 power minus 9 by epsilon naught into A cap Z. This is the resultant. ES is equal to this much, minus 0.1 into 10 power minus 9 A cap Z divided by epsilon naught. So we will get 2 times of this, numerator 2 and denominator 2 gets cancelled, and we left with this quantity. So continuing with this, solve for EL. What is EL? Electric field intensity due to line charge, that is rho L. What is the value of rho L given? 2 nanocoulomb. 2 into 10 power minus 9 divided by, what is the value? 2 pi epsilon naught into R. What is the value of R? So we don't know this vector R, A cap R and R. Let me solve this. How to solve A cap R? A cap R is equal to R divided by magnitude of R. How to solve this? See here, 1 minus 1, 0, minus 7 minus 7, 0, then 2 minus 0, 2, okay? So, we left with only 2 into A cap Z divided by square root of 2 square. What we are going to get? So, the magnitude of R is 2, therefore, magnitude of R becomes 2. This is the unit vector given. Okay, this is the value. Substitute here. So magnitude of R is 2. Then this becomes what we are going to get. See, A cap R is 2 A cap Z divided by 2 square means 4. Root 4 is 2. 2 to get cancelled. We left with A cap Z only. Got it? Then solve this. Then EL is equal to 2 and 2 gets cancelled, 10 power minus 9 divided by 2 pi epsilon naught into A cap Z, okay, volt per meter. What is the final step? E is equal to EL plus ES. E is equal to adding these two quantities, this one and this one. So EL is 10 power minus 9 divided by 2 pi epsilon naught into a cap z minus 0.1 into 10 power minus 9 divided by epsilon naught into a cap z. Okay, since we have negative sign here, no need to write plus again. So let us reduce one more step. Therefore, a total electric field intensity E is equal to, take common all these terms common, az is common here, divided by epsilon naught is common, so we left with, and 10 power minus 9 also common, 1 divided by 2 pi minus 0.1. this is the value we left. See here, 10 power minus 9 is taken outside, epsilon naught is taken outside, az is taken outside. We left with 1 divided by 2 pi in this term and minus 0.1 in this particular term. Therefore, if we try to solve this by taking LCM and all, we are going to get 6.68 into a cap z volt per meter. This is the total electric field intensity at this particular point P due to line charge along y-axis and infinite area surface charge along the z plane. So we cannot expect on the axis here, so we need to consider plane because this is a surface charge of infinite area. Got it? This is how you need to solve when two different type of charges have been given. Got it? Thank you. Continue with the next problem. Find the electric field intensity E at origin in the following charge distributions are present in free space. The first condition given is with respect to point charge. A point charge 12 nanocoulomb at P is equal to 2, 0 and 6. The coordinate of point P where the electric field intensity to be identified is given as 2, 0, 6. The second condition is uniform line charge of rho L. Line charge density is given 3 nanocoulomb at x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 3. And third condition given is uniform surface charge of surface charge density rho s is given by 0.2 nanocoulomb per meter square at x is equal to 2. In all the three cases, we need to calculate the electric field intensity at the origin. So total electric field intensity E. Therefore, total electric field intensity E is contributed by electric field intensity E1 by point charge plus electric field intensity E2 by line charge plus electric field intensity E3 by surface charge. These three different electric field intensities by using different configurations contributed together to form the total electric field intensity at origin. Therefore, we need to apply superposition theorem here again. So let us consider the calculation of E1 first. What is E1? Electric field intensity due to point charge, 12 nanocoulomb of point charge. Okay, let us describe the problem statement. We need to have a point P from origin 0, 0, 0, since it is given as origin, it is 0, 0, 0. Let us name it as point A and let us name this point as P. So this is 2, 0, 6. Okay, unit vector is acting towards this, so distance between these two points is considered as R. So what is the equation for electric field intensity at a point P due to a point charge? We know the equation as E1 is equal to what? Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into R square into a cap R. What is a cap R? A cap R is unit vector. Let us solve for unit vector. A cap R is equal to R divided by magnitude of R. Vector R divided by magnitude of R. How to calculate this? Again, we need to use the distance formula, right? 2 minus 0, tip minus tail rule. 2 minus 0, 0 minus 0, 6 minus 0. Okay, like this we need to calculate. Remember this, we need to calculate at the origin. Therefore, the direction is to not this way. Direction is this way. The unit vector is acting along this point. Okay, so you need to calculate at the origin. Look at the problem statement. So at the origin we need to calculate. E at origin. Therefore, the vector acting towards the origin, the direction is reversed. Hence, 0 minus 2, 0 minus 0, 0 minus 6. We need to have this kind of things. 0 minus 2 into a cap x plus 0 minus 0 into a cap y plus 0 minus 6 into a cap z whole divided by magnitude of all these things, that is minus 2 whole square plus minus 6 whole square. So what is the value we are going to get? A cap r is equal to how much? A cap r is equal to minus 2 a cap x minus 6 a cap z divided by square root of 40. Because 2 square is 4, 6 square is 36, 36 plus 4, square root of 40. If we try to solve this, what we are going to get is minus 0.316 a cap x minus 0.949 a cap z. This is the unit vector we have got. Now substitute this unit vector into this equation. Therefore, E1 becomes, what is the value of Q given? 12 nanocoulomb, 12 into 10 power minus 9 nanocoulomb divided by 4 pi into, what is the value of epsilon naught? 8.854 into 10 power minus 12 into R square. R square means, what is the value of R we have got? R is equal to root 40. What about R square? R square is equal to 40. Substitute 40 here. 40 into, what is A cap R? A cap R is this much. Minus 0.316 A cap X minus 0.949 A cap Z. After taking root 40 into numerator, 2 divided by root 40, 6 divided by root 40, we have got this term, right? So after solving this, we have got this quantity. So by solving this equation, E1 becomes minus 0.852 a cap x minus 2.559 a cap z. What is the unit? Volt per meter. This is E1. This is the first case, okay, for point charge. First case for point charge. Point charge. We have found out the electric field intensity at origin due to point P for a point charge. Okay. Now the second case is E2 due to line charge. Line charge. So we need to have a line charge at point P. We need to calculate the electric field intensity at origin 0, 0, 0. Okay. So distance between these two is AR. The unit vector is A cap R acting towards this point. So what is the coordinate of this point given? X is equal to 2 and Y is equal to 3. Therefore, the coordinate of this point is 2, 3, 0. 2, 3, 0. So what is the equation for electric field intensity? E2 is equal to rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon naught into R into A cap R. This is the equation. This is the equation for infinite length uniform line charge. Okay. So this is the equation. So rho L value is given, that is 3 nanocoulomb. So we don't know the a cap r and r quantity, we need to calculate that, right? So calculation of a cap r is equal to, use this equation, tip minus tail, 0 minus 2 into a cap x plus 0 minus 3 into a cap y. Z component is not there, just leave it. Minus 2 square plus minus 3 square. What is the value we have got? A cap r is equal to minus 2 a cap x minus 3 a cap y divided by square root of how much? 4 plus 9 plus 4, 13, square root of 13. So finally a cap r is equal to minus 0.55 a cap x minus 0.832 a cap y. This much we have got. Now calculate e2. E2 is equal to rho l. What is the value of rho l given? 3 nanocoulomb. 3 into 10 power minus 9 divided by 2 pi into epsilon naught. 8.854 into 10 power minus 12 into r. What is the value of r? Value of r is root 13. Root 13 into a cap r. Into a cap r. What is the value of a cap r? This is minus 0.55 a cap x minus 0.832 a cap y. This is the term we need to substitute. After solving this, e2 will be equal to minus 8.3 a cap x minus 12.48 a cap y volt per meter. This is the quantity, electric field intensity due to uniform line charge at point P with coordinate 2, 3, 0 induced at origin. E2 is given by this term. Now what is the next thing we need to calculate? E3. What is E3? E3 is the electric field intensity due to surface charge. Surface charge. Okay. Calculation of E3. Third case, E3 due to surface charge. So what is the equation for that? E3 is equal to rho s divided by 2 epsilon naught into a cap r. Rho s divided by 2 epsilon naught into a cap r. This is the equation. So what is a cap r? Since they have given with only x is equal to 0, so what is a cap r for this particular thing? A cap r is equal to minus 2 a cap x divided by, what is the value of this one? Square root of 2 square. Square root of 2 square, that means 2. A cap r is equal to minus a cap x for this particular thing. Substitute here. Rho s is given, epsilon naught is given. Just substitute directly. Rho s is, what is the value? 0.2 into 10 power minus 9 nanocoulomb per centimeter square divided by 2 into 8.854 into 10 power minus 12 into a cap r. What is a cap r? Minus a cap x into minus a cap x. Only this much. After solving this, E3 is given by minus 11.29 a cap x volt per meter. Minus 11.29 a cap x volt per meter. Now the overall agenda is to calculate E, that is total electric field intensity E due to point charge, line charge and surface charge. Sum all the three quantities, this one and this one. After summing all the three quantities, what you are going to get is E is equal to minus 20.44 a cap x minus 12.48 a cap y minus 2.55 a cap z volt per meter. This is the overall electric field intensity at origin due to point uniform line charge and uniform surface charge. Okay, this is how you need to solve a problem with three different charges. Understood? Thank you.